You don't listen to your alocasia, Polly. Watch this. The leaves in your alocasia pulley could be turning yellow for a number of reasons. So let's go over the most common causes to get to the bottom of this. Number one, some yellowing is natural. If your alocasia is producing new leaves and the older ones are turning yellow and dropping, this may be part of the natural cycle of your plant. Your alocasia is shedding the old growth to give space for the new growth. This is particularly if the leaves that are yellowing are the ones at the bottom. And your alocasia, again, is producing new growth. However, yellowing of the leaves in your alocasia may mean that she's just not happy. So let's see what could be the problem. Number two, overwatering. If the leaves of your alocasia are becoming yellow, this can be a very good sign that you may be overwatering your plant. Now, I know that the alocasias prefer to have moist soil at all times, but we should still let the soil dry out a little bit before we water again. Remember, they want the soil to be moist, but not wet or oversaturated. A way to prevent overwatering your plant is to always check the soil before you water. I always check with my finger. I stick my finger in the soil, and if I feel that the soil is still moist, I don't water. I only water when I feel that the soil is drying out. I also use the bottom watering method to prevent overwatering my plant. This is because with this method, I get the water into the roots from below, and after 10 to 15 minutes, I take it out of the water and I let the excess water drain down through the drainage holes. That way, I make sure that the soil is moist but not wet. And always make sure that the pot is not too big for your plant. If the pot is very big, the alocasia won't be able to take all of the water in, and as a result, it will be standing in water, which in turn will cause overwatering and root rot. Number three, underwatering. I know, it could be overwatering, but it can also be underwatering. As I said before, the alocasia likes to keep the soil moist at all times, so we shouldn't let the soil dry out completely, as in the case with succulents, for example. With the alocasia, we want the soil to dry out, but not completely dry out. That is too dry for her. Remember, this plant is not drought tolerant, so always check the soil. What I usually do is I check the soil every week, and once I feel that the soil is drying out, then I water. Number four, and this is very important, lack of humidity. The alocasia is a tropical plant. It is a hybrid between the Alocasia longiloba and the Alocasia sanderiana. And these two come from Asia, from the jungles in Asia, to be more specific. So they really like tropical conditions, and therefore they like high humidity. I can tell you, we have this alocasia in our bedroom where we have a humidifier and we keep the humidity levels about 50 to 60%. And she is very happy like that. If your alocasia is lacking humidity and you have her in a room where the air is really dry, the edges of the leaves will brown and this will be followed by yellowing of the leaves. So make sure that you raise humidity around her. Next common cause for yellowing of the leaves, and I find that here in Berlin, this is a very common cause for this, is lack of light. In the winter, if you live in Germany or any city in the North Hemisphere, we get way less sunlight. So I find, for example, that people that live in Berlin tend to have many yellow leaves in their alocasias, especially in the winter. So what I would recommend is that you raise the light for your alocasia. They like bright sunlight. Not bright direct sunlight because they will burn the leaves, but bright indirect sunlight. For example, I have this one under a grow light. The light doesn't go directly at her. There are some layers of other leaves in between, but she gets bright light the whole day. And I find that this is helping her. Actually, this leaf right here is a new leaf. And we are in December, so I think she's happy like that. And the last common cause may be pests, especially spider mites, which I read are very attracted to this plant when it is not happy. Spider mites actually don't like humidity. So if your plant is in a space with dry air, this is already not going to be the best for your plant, but it will also attract some pests such as spider mites. So what I always recommend is that you always check your plant. So you should check the leaf from the top, then the bottom, and also the stems and the soil. If you find that your plant has been attacked by pests, I recommend that you do your research on which pest it is and how you can treat it. Just in case, I have a playlist that you can check out with many common pests on houseplants and how to treat them. So if this is the case with your plant, I recommend you check it out. Let me know if any of these causes ring a bell for your plant or if you have experienced anything different. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Okay, ciao!